Seconds to depletion. 25 seconds to depletion. 20 seconds to depletion. 15 seconds to depletion. 10 seconds to depletion. Take the depletion. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fuck.
24 hours in a day. 1,440 separate minutes in which someone could meet their end at the hands of someone who may or may not look like me. 86,400 seconds in each and every one of which someone could breathe their last. All that time to be accounted for. All 31,536,000 separate seconds of life and death, each and every year. Monday the 13th of October 2003. First 9 hours covered. Will today be the day? Things to remember. 1. Paranoia is a malfunction of the ability to reason. I can reason, therefore I am not paranoid. 2. The principal characteristics of the paranoid personality are delusions, hostility, suspicions. I am not deluded. I am not suspicious. I may be hostile, but that's only because they are out to get me. April the 18th, 1994.
Chaos erupted at the High Court today following the sensational collapse of the trial against alleged triple murderer Sean Vale. Citing a pre-trial barrage of biased media reports as being prejudicial to Mr. Vale's defense, Lord Justice Kagan threw the case out and lambasted those in charge of the investigation, Detective Inspector Lewis Emmerich and forensic profiler Saul Seeger, for contriving an investigative strategy that essentially amounted to trial by tabloid.
What happened on the High Court today was a tragedy. For the Jasper family, justice has not been done, nor has it been seen to be done. In the wake of this outcome, and I stress the word outcome, not verdict, I think it's important to remember that the accused was not cleared of this crime. And that while the file on the Jasper murders will remain open, the police are not currently looking for anyone else in connection with it. Thank you.
Excuse me. I would just like to add that the pathology of the Jasper murders suggests that the killer is highly likely to strike again. If and when he does, which I, for one, predict he will, let me take this opportunity to assure him categorically that there will be no escape from justice a second time.
Nine years, 11 months, 28 days, and 1,553 murders since. 975 still unsolved. How many more have they thought about pinning on me? Lindsay Martell. Jacqueline Jones, the Bolton baby. 975 murders unsolved. 1,615 children without mothers. 10,323 brothers, sisters, friends, and relatives all bereaved, all thinking that maybe it was me.
Probing the psyche of sexual predators, of those who rob, rape, torture, and kill to exert their superiority over a world they are otherwise unable to affect, is not a job for the faint of heart. You have to see how the killer sees, think how he thinks. In a very real sense, you have to enter his mind and become the killer. In this country alone, there are some 600 such predators out there who have thus far escaped justice. These men, and by far the majority of them are men, are living and working among us. Expert at presenting a benign and unthreatening face to the world they secretly loathe. They are the husbands, fathers, sons and friends of ordinary working people. Indeed, some could be sitting among us here today. This book will help you recognize the hidden signs that point to the darkness invisible in the hearts of Britain's uncaught killers. Killers who could be lying next to you in bed at night, dreaming of the time that they will strike again. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, I'm happy to take a few questions. Yes.
Mr. Seeger, my name's Katie Carter. I'm a reporter from Crime Wave.
I know who you are, Miss Carter, yes.
I heard on the radio this morning that your book's being published to coincide with the 10th anniversary of the murder... the barbaric slaughter, I should say, of Susan Jasper and her daughters. Yet nowhere within it do you advance any new theories as to who the suspect might be or how he might be brought to justice.
There's a very good reason for that, Miss Carter. My book is about the uncaught killers of unsolved crimes.
Yes.
Well, I don't consider the Jasper murders to be unsolved.
But you're saying you know who the killer is, surely?
I am saying that I stand by my opinion I formed 10 years ago. I am further saying that the type of man who can turn a gun on a pair of 6-year-old twin girls, never mind their parents, is someone the public will always be at risk from until they're under lock and key or 6 feet of earth.
In that case, Mr. Seeger, would you accept that it's your fault he's out on the streets?
I beg your pardon.
If you hadn't attempted to entrap Sean Vale into confessing, the trial against him would not have collapsed.
The libel laws of this country forbid me from openly expressing my views on this case, young lady. However, what I will say is this. I remain confident that time will prove me right on the Jasper case, as it has done on so many others. Now, if you don't mind, there are plenty of other people here who would like to ask me some questions. Yes, sir.
I have a question!
Call security now!
How does an innocent man get justice in this country? How does he get his reputation back? His sanity?
Is this some kind of setup?
You ought to know, Seeger. Your field of expertise, isn't it?
My field of expertise, as you, sir, know all too well, lies in the accurate identification of murder suspects from the painstaking analysis of crime scene information.
Identification of suckers, you mean? Dupes! Dupes!
You were there, Vale. You were in the vicinity. You were seen.
I was out walking. I wasn't doing anyone any harm. I did nothing wrong. I'm an innocent man. I am an innocent man. I did nothing wrong.
Shout it out loudly enough, Vale. Someone might believe you. Not me. I know different. I'm in there, Vale. I'm inside your mind. I know all the perverted fantasies you harbor, the dark dreams. I know you better than you know yourself.
No, you leave me alone. The Jasper kid is still out there. I did nothing wrong, Seeger. You know that. No.
I suppose I want to thank you, Miss Carter, for all the free publicity.
You don't have the right, man. I'm not a criminal here. I'm not the one making money out of murder.
I'm the one getting jailed for railway combat.
Mr. Vale, I heard what you said up there.
Is he recording this?
Yes, but I can get him to turn it off if you like.
No, no,
really, I don't mind. I'm perfectly happy to talk off camera.
Off camera? So I've no evidence, no alibi, nothing to prove where I was. It's 3:30 this afternoon, so I can be accused of something someone else is doing somewhere else right now.
No, I meant, well, please, whatever suits you best. I was just wondering if I could have a quick word.
I don't give interviews. Not without editorial control. Words can be distorted, re-edited. Things can be made to seem other than what they are.
It wasn't an interview I had in mind, Mr. Vale. Not in the conventional sense.
I've got to go.
Mr. Vale, wait, please! Shit.
Things to remember. 3. It's everywhere. All around me, the threat. Once you feel it, you never lose it. They make sure of that. It's a war of nerves, constant, ongoing, never ending. How can they think I'm a criminal when I spend my life ensuring I'm seen? When I seek out what others avoid? When even my appearance is designed to stick in people's minds? If I could, I'd live here. Set up home right on this spot to be surveilled. Constantly to have my whereabouts known to all and sundry. The facts, verifiable, indisputable, would be heaven.
Who's there? I know there's someone there. Have you followed me?
I've been waiting for you.
Where's your cameraman?
I sent him home hours ago, but I can always get him back.
No, I already told you my
policy on interviews.
What about your policy on reconstructions?
You're reconstructing the Jasper murders.
Advance copy. Due for transmission the night of the anniversary. I thought you might like to take a look at it.
So I can see myself being stitched up again? Framed?
It's not that kind of reconstruction, Mr. Vale, honestly.
What other kind is there?
Well, take a look and find out.
Am I in it?
You're mentioned.
But nobody's playing me.
Brad Pitt was unavailable.
What?
Joke.
Have you got time for this?
What I'm saying, Mr. Vale, what I'm offering is the chance for you to play yourself. No one likes to see an innocent man entrapped by the police.
That's what I was. What I am.
We could reconstruct your movements on the night. You could show us what you saw, what you heard.
I didn't see anything. Why are you so interested in this case, anyway? There are hundreds of unsolved murders out there for you lot to get your teeth into. Even a cretin like Seeger knows that.
Because Susan Jasper was my mother. Moira and Maggie were my sisters. I was staying at a friend's the night it happened. Then maybe you'll believe this. Carter was my mother's maiden name. I took it when I left school. I'd never been allowed to work on the Jasper case if they'd known who I was. How many cameras are running in here?
In here? Five. In the entire place. 19.
After this footage was filmed, three of the family members would be dead, and the fourth would only survive after extensive life-saving surgery. For Susan Jasper, her husband Sam, and their six-year-old twin daughters Moira and Maggie, the birthday celebrations would soon turn to unimaginable horror. It was here, in this isolated farmhouse, that the killer struck between 10 p.m. and 12 midnight. No one knows I'm here, I promise.
Sight for sore eyes, that's what you're thinking, right? No? Well, you certainly are, Val. Seeing you there, all vulnerable like that, almost makes me a believer.
Believer?
Visualization therapy. Doctors say you've just got to visualize the thing you most want in the world, and hey, presto, it'll come to pass.
That was true. You'd be dead long since.
Maybe we'll both get what we want, eh, Val?
Well, well, well. Miss Carter.
I didn't touch her.
I haven't touched her, I swear. She begged to come in. You can check my tapes. The camera's running the entire time.
Running, were they? These cameras? 5 years ago?
Been running for the last 10. Thanks to you.
In that case, where do you keep your, what do you call them? Rushes. Someone particular we'd like a look at.
Just give me a time and a date.
October the 15th, 1998, between... Mountjoy?
7 p.m. and midnight.
Shouldn't be a problem.
I wish you could always just tell us what you were doing 5 years ago, Val.
Can you tell me what you were doing to the night?
I could tell you I wasn't brutally assaulting and murdering a 25-year-old woman called Mary Shaw.
That makes two of us then, doesn't it?
He's killed someone else.
I haven't killed anyone. Ever. And I can prove it. I just need to go in there.
Is that where you keep your tapes?
All 97,663 of them.
Plenty to keep you amused when they put you away, then. Be able to watch the lot three times over. Stick with him.
All right, if I take this... I'd like to keep a record.
We've noticed.
So this is it. done it. They've got to me. Somehow they've set me up. I was right all along, despite everything. I just wasn't careful enough.
Is that it?
Done and dusted. I must maintain control. Can't let them see I'm upset. I haven't come this far. Eluded their efforts for so long. To fail now. Ah. Oh. Shit. I forgot a tape. Do you mind if I go back and get it?
Fuck's sake. Hurry up, this place can be the fucking creeps. What is it with you anyway? Some kind of mole or something?
Home in the darkness, if that's what you mean.
What the fuck? I'm sorry, you're right. You left me no choice.
John! Open this fucking gate! John!
Oh, man, I didn't come here. Lock me up and throw away the key. I've heard that one before.
To remember four. The first law of forensics, Lockhart's theory. Every contact leaves a trace. If I leave nothing anywhere, there'd be nothing they can trace back to me.
Thank you. I don't know who you are or what you want.
That's very odd. Because not 12 hours ago, you were telling me you know me better than I know myself.
Vale.
You finally got something right, didn't you, Sherlock?
Oh, you are in a shitload of trouble, my friend.
Perfect. Unless I'm mistaken, you're the one being held at knife point by supposed quadruple killer. But then again, what do I know? I'm not the expert in crime scene analysis.
What do you want?
You're inside my mind. You tell me. Perhaps I'm here to fulfill one of my perverted fantasies, one of my dark dreams.
You won't get away with this, Vale.
According to you, I've already got away with killing an entire fucking family!
Okay. If you want to talk about the Jasper murders, I suggest you put the knife down now.
There are only six things I'm interested in discussing with you. Seeger. They're manufactured by Sony. They last 1 hour each. And they cover the times between 6 p.m. and 12 at night, October the 15th, 1998. You've got them. And I want them.
You've lost me, Vale.
The only thing being lost in this room is my patience, surely to be followed by your fucking life!
Now look. Look at me. You're distraught. I can see that. You're angry at yourself for finally being caught, and blaming me is probably some last-ditch strategy. In my professional opinion, Vale.
Don't you dare. Don't you fucking dare try to profile me, you bastard. Professional opinion. Professional fucking bullshit. You wouldn't know a criminal if it came up and robbed you at gunpoint.
I tell you what I do know, Vale, is that I know that you're not going to use this knife on me.
Oh, no. Saying your prayers.
What I meant, Vale, is that you're the type of killer that can't bear to get his hands dirty, that can't bear to get up close and personal. A knife is not your kind of weapon, Vale. It takes guts to use a knife. No, a coward like you needs to use a gun to get some distance, to put you at one remove from the event so that you can observe it, so that you can stand outside of it whilst it's happening. Probably relates to an innate voyeurism with its roots in an abusive childhood.
Get away from there.
Go straight to the local police station. You're going nowhere. Stop wriggling my deviant. Thank you.
things to unlearn. One. CCTV is to be avoided. Can't claim I was on Oxford Street if a camera picks me up in Port Neath. It won't be easy. Seeking out cameras is encoded in my DNA. I'm drawn to them. Like a cop to corruption. Like Emmerich to a payoff.
I'm seeing it, but I don't believe it. Don't mind telling you, Vel. Beginning to frighten me, this visualization thing. I imagined you sitting there, and there you are. Anyone would think our destinies are connected.
You just visualize me pleading guilty. See how that works. If I had anything to hide, I wouldn't have added myself in, would I?
You had nothing to hide. You wouldn't have run off.
October 15th, 1998, Sean. Let's just start with that. Where were you then? Who were you with? What were you doing? Answer those questions to our satisfaction.
And you'll see to it that the evidence is fabricated to the contrary, and I won't see the light of day for 15 years.
30, I am my way.
Can I use this?
What it's there for?
Me there. Not the railway rapist. You've got him.
We know that, Sean.
What we want to know is where you are.
Port Neath. I went away for the day and the night.
Strange time of year to go to the seaside.
It's precisely why I went. Less crowds. You can see in the next shot.
Hasn't changed much over the years, has he, Mountjoy?
He's even got a cut on his lip. I'm not an expert. I think you've been using makeup, Sean. Could have been shot yesterday, this.
Do you know what time code is?
Yep. And I also know it can be adjusted on certain cameras.
Maybe it can. Maybe it can't. Look. You can't alter a specific headline in a newspaper, though, can you? Anyone can see that's the 15th of the 10th of 98. You can check with the newspaper if you don't believe me.
Could do. Then again, we could just pop down the local library and nick a copy.
I don't know what you're trying to imply, but I do know this. I'm covered. I'm alibied up.
Talking of which, where were you at 11:45 the same night?
12:45. You ever turn that thing off?
Give you a lot of chance to fit me up? No way.
Christ's sake, just get it to 11:45, will you?
Satisfied?
My curiosity isn't.
Nor mine.
You see, the thing is, Vale, nothing you've shown me explains this.
They're not mine.
No one's saying they are.
Mine are all clearly marked.
Meticulously so. We had noticed.
So, what's the problem?
You're about to find out.
Celebrating.
Sorry?
Bad luck to drink champagne on your own. You are on your own, aren't you?
Looks younger there, Mountjoy, can you say?
About 5 years.
Yes.
Give or take.
Kathy. Kathy Burton.
Tom Prophet. Tom Prophet. Okay. So I give some girl a false name in a bar. And so would you, in my position. My notoriety. It's not a hanging offence.
Sean, we don't hang people anymore.
Unfortunately.
Besides, I thought this was about Mary Shaw.
It is.
But she said...
Kathy. Kathy Burton.
And you said...
Tom Prophet. Tom Prophet. I know. What's she doing filming me anyway?
Question is, why don't your tapes match hers, Val?
An unusual name. Don't suppose you foresee anything interesting happening to us tonight, do you?
This is a setup. Any fool can see that.
You didn't.
Well, aren't you with anyone?
Stood me up. Expect you find that hard to believe.
I'll get you folks another glass.
So, you keep it running all the time, the camera?
24/7, 52.
Cool. I'm serious.
condom. From behind.
What?
It's nothing personal. I have to take precautions.
Usually me saying that. Come on. I think it's time you filled me up.
Well?
Well, what? The man that should be sitting here was the man that sent you those tapes. The man that paid her to film me, to set me up.
No one sent us those tapes, Vale. We found them on a body. She was still wired up when she was killed. Yes, sometimes you just get lucky on an investigation, hmm?
Sure you're okay with this?
Can't wait.
Okay. It's only tour inside, across the threshold, so to speak.
Till you've hid your girlfriend's knickers, you mean?
Look, I know how this looks.
So do we, Vale. So will the jury.
Careful. Right? Uh-huh. Don't look. Okay, it won't be a moment. Now stay there, all right? Okay.
What the fuck is this shit?
You promised you wouldn't look. I didn't mean for you to see it.
I want to go. No one said anything about this.
No one. No one who?
Heard that, did you? I'd make a note of that time code if I were you. Liable to be a cornerstone in my defence, this ever comes to call. You heard what she said. No one said anything about this. No one. That means someone. Someone sent her. Someone put her up to this. He's the one you should be looking for, not me.
Get the fuck away from me, you freak.
Look, I don't know who you've been talking to, who sent you. But yes, I was accused of murder once. Accused, not convicted, I was accused. It could happen to anybody, wrong place, wrong time, wrong interest in life, and bam, you're down like a ton of bricks.
Back up! I'm screaming that fucking place down!
Okay, look, you can leave any time you like. I'm not stopping you.
No, you're gonna kill me, aren't you?
No,
I've
no.
seen all those things, and now you're gonna kill me.
No, no, I've never killed anyone. I just don't want you running off in a panic. It's dark out there. It's late. It's dangerous. Let me get you a taxi.
I don't want to.
It'll only take a minute.
Taxi, I just want to go. Please, I won't tell anybody.
Tell anyone? There's nothing to tell.
Exactly. I know that now. I'm just... Look, my flatmates will be looking for me. If I don't come home, they'll call the police.
Hey, at least let me walk you then. Yeah?
Walk me.
Yeah. I don't want you running off on your own. Anything could happen. People have seen us together. I'll get blamed.
You want to walk me in the dark down those streets?
Yeah.
You.
Just until we see a taxi. I'll pay, nothing dodgy, proper black cab and everything. You let me put you in it. I'll take the driver's number and license plate, and that'll be there. I'll film you driving off, and then no one can accuse me of anything. I'll know you're safe, and we can part company amicably. Yeah?
All right. All right, on one condition.
Yes, yes, anything. Yes, please.
You let me go to the street first, on my own.
Yeah. Yes, but you'll have to let me get the door, because it's... bit stiff.
You saw what happened? She knocked me unconscious.
and then she ran off. I mean, whatever happened after that, it's got nothing to do with me.
Girl comes back to your flat, gets blindfolded, disappears off the face of the earth for 5 years, then turns up dead. And you say it's got nothing to do with you.
I offered to get her a cab. I begged her to get her a cab. You heard me. I was concerned with her safety. It's all there on film. Camera doesn't lie.
Someone's camera's lying. Face it, Val. Your 90-odd thousand videotapes aren't worth the stock they're recorded on.
That's what this is about, isn't it? Discrediting my archive. My safety net. Everything I've worked for, built up to protect me from you.
I've got something to show you. Time to say hello to an old friend, Vale.
I don't want to see her. I don't want any more images in my head.
Well, you've got to face up to your crime sometimes, Sean. Think of it as therapy. First step on the long, hard road to rehabilitation.
As a psychologist acquaintance of mine used to say, there's no cure without confrontation. Isn't that right, Saul?
You think I did this?
Your fingerprints are on the knife, Saul.
Wearing gloves.
No.
Blood on the carpet's a perfect match for your DNA.
Police saw you running from the scene.
He was alive then. I can prove it. I've got it on tape.
Time of death was 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon, Val. You got yourself on tape then?
Yesterday afternoon.
Come on, Sean. Cat got your tongue?
Got his tapes, more like.
You did this. You did this. You set me up. You killed Mary Shaw and stole my tapes, so I'd have to make new ones. Nothing to prove where I was. I knew it was this.
You seem kind of relaxed, if you don't mind me saying, for a man who's about to spend the next 30 years sucking unwashed dick.
You seem kind of jealous, if you don't mind me saying.
Mark Joy!
Let him go.
Let him what?
You heard me.
I don't understand.
Thank you.
to guide the Shadow. Keep him under surveillance the entire time he was in Port Neath.
Always do when I feel I need some extra insurance. No way I was going to leave myself an entire day short.
You're wasting your time. He's covered for yesterday. He's got 24 hours of tape and a witness. We've got nothing to hold him on.
What about Mary Shaw? He's not covered for her.
Other tapes after the ones that went missing show him at home after she left. Fight him in a cabin. It's not enough. Not after the last time.
But he's already discredited his tapes.
You lot is discredited.
Well, go on. Fuck off. Before we change our minds.
Little broken body staring sightless at the ceiling. Maggie Jasper. Pathologist cut into her with one of these. Practically sliced her in two in front of me. You ever intended a postmortem, Belle?
No, I suppose I have. You just like to cause them, don't you?
Well, don't worry. You'll be attending one soon.
Bastard!
I'm not leaving you behind, Bear. I'm taking you with me. Hear me, Bear!
Be 100 more of these going off, you run round there. Word's out, you got away with it again.
I haven't done anything to get away with. This time or the last.
What happened to your neck?
Police brutality, that's what happened to my neck. It's Emmerich you should be exposing, not me.
Come on, get in. Entitle me to an exclusive, that. In the normal course of affairs.
Yeah, I can see that now. Victim's daughter rescues killer from lynch mob.
Killer? Is that a confession, Sean Vale?
No. Are you wired?
Happy? Or would you like me to remove my bra as well?
You didn't have to do that. You could have just said yes or no.
Would you have believed me?
Would you believe me if I told you I did not kill Mary Shaw? I did not kill
Yes. Aren't you going to ask me why? Because I know who killed my mother and sisters. And I know it wasn't you. The evidence would suggest otherwise. Sean, playing with your mind. Profiler's games. Convince Emmerich if you saw him dead, it would push you over the edge. Get you to break down. Confess to the Mary Shaw thing. Very least, figured it would open up a crack in your defense. Cast doubt on the provenance of your tapes.
How do you know all this?
Asked me to do it first, didn't he? Be the guinea pig. Play dead. Thought if you were in the frame for killing me, surviving Jasper daughter, you'd go right off the deep end. I almost agreed to it. Then I had a better idea. While he was off playing corpse, gave me a chance to look through his house. Always thought the evil fucker knew more about the murders than he was letting on. And I was right. Guess what I found? 9mm Beretta. Jasper murder weapon, Sean. Finally got it in your hands.
He did it. He killed your family. It was him.
Think about it. Before the Jasper murders, what was he? A small-time, small-town psychologist working with petty ex-offenders like you. I looked into his past. I tried to get into the cops and failed. What better way to get one up on the profession that had rejected him than commit a headline-grabbing murder, then move in and solve it? What better way to get a fat leg onto the profiling ladder?
Don't listen to her, Will. She's the one playing games with you. She's trying to get you to kill me.
For a so-called profiling genius, Seeger, you have an amazing knack of getting things wrong. He's not gonna kill you. I am.
No, I don't want any part of this. Please.
Been a part of it from the beginning, Sean. Might as well be here for the end.
Please, not here.
Listen to him, young Jasper! He's talking sense. Besides, if you kill me, you're beginning the wrong person. If you kill me, the truth will die with me.
What's he on about?
He's gonna say I did it again. Save his own skin.
Need a skull made of Kevlar to do that. I found this gun in your house, Seeger. I've had it tested.
Did you test it for prints?
Prints? No point. Guy like you, forensically aware, would have wiped it clean.
A guy like me would never have had it in my house in the first place. My finger had been on the trigger.
My prints are on that gun now. He's gonna say I planted it. That's what he's gonna say.
He's gonna say what he was doing with it or he's gonna die. That's what he's going to say.
Someone sent it me, okay?
I should have got rid of it long since, but I suffer from the enthusiast malady. I kept it as a souvenir, a piece of crime memorabilia for my own black museum.
Classic serial killer behavior, keeping souvenirs. Says so in his own books.
I'm a collector, Vale, not a killer.
You're a lying prick is what you are.
Who sent it to you?
The truth isn't always the panacea we imagine it to be, Katie Jasper. But if you really want to know who killed your mother and sisters...
I do.
Then I suggest you slice open your arm.
What?
The blood of your family's killer runs in your own veins. Your father sent me that gun and a note confessing everything. The day the trial against Vale collapsed, the day your father hung himself.
My father hung himself because he couldn't live without Mum. Without Maura and Maggie.
Couldn't live with killing them, you mean?
No.
He thought that your mother had been having an affair. He thought that Moira and Maggie weren't his. That is why he shot them in the face.
No.
To show his hatred, his contempt. Wouldn't have got away with it at the time if your mother hadn't tried to wrestle the gun off him. If she hadn't wounded him in the struggle. Gave him an out, a means to turn the investigation away from him.
It's not true. It's a lie. If that's the truth, why didn't you tell?
I just gained a foothold in my profession. I had to stick to my guns. I had to stick to my theory that it was Vale. I didn't want my reputation undermined any more than you would want yours, any more than you'd want to be known as the daughter of a killer. Catches criminals, takes them off the streets, puts them behind bars where they belong. Now, I may have been a little economical with the truth as regards this, but stop her, Vale! And I'll exonerate you, I swear! She's only gonna blame it on you, Vale! Why else do you think he's doing it here? For God's sake, man! Do something! Who do you think killed Mary Shaw?
It was an accident. This is deliberate. I expect you'll want to thank me for that. What? Do you think he's still alive? Do you think this is another stunt?
It was. from there.
Let me see. Sure you mean that, Sean?
Yes.
Doesn't feel like it to me.
No. Don't.
How long's it been, Sean? 3 years? 5? I bet the last woman you had down here was Mary.
I didn't touch her.
No. But you wanted to. She told me. Told me you'd freaked her out.
Death had nothing to do with me.
You're right. Responsibility for that lies at my door. Me who hired her. Me who asked her to do what I'm doing to you now. Get a sample of your DNA. Semen, preferably. Something I could use to set you up. Fabricate a rape charge. Came on all heavy afterwards, Mary. Said you'd put the fear of God into her. I should have warned you, Beth.
Is that it?
It's all right.
Fuck off.
Don't touch that! Next thing I knew, thought about trying to implicate you at the time, but I was younger then and frightened. I panicked. In the end, I just buried her along with the tapes. Thought I'd wait till someone came across her. Bide my time. Coming up to the anniversary, anonymous phone call was all it took. That and getting your tapes. Why, I was there that night before the rift.
It was you.
Thought they might exonerate you. Thought I might be seen on them. I was in the bar that night. Watching.
Get off of me!
How long do you think you can hold out, Sean?
I've held out for 10 years.
Come on. Let it go. You know you want to.
Never have sex without a condom. Once they get hold of your sperm, you're fucked.
You're going to accuse me of all this, aren't you? Say I killed Seagull, raped you. You don't have to do this, you know. As far as I'm concerned, Seeger had it coming. We're both victims here. We're both...
And when they come and arrest you for Mary Shaw, when they decide they can prosecute you on the evidence of her tapes alone, when they come for you for Seeger, for real, what are you going to say, Sean? You're right, Detective Inspector Emmerich, sir. It was me. I admit it. Don't worry, Sean. This is one part of your life that won't be going on tape.
Jesus Christ. And you filmed all this? Confessions, shootings, everything? Her fucking you. You.
Strange as it may seem.
So where's the tapes?
She torched them.
Right. That's it. Sean Vale, I'm arresting you on suspicion of the murders of Katie Carter.
Aye.
Believe me, Sean, but I'm genuinely sorry to have to do this to you. After all these years, I just couldn't cope with people looking at me the way they probably look at you. Thinking killer's blood runs through her veins.
It does.
Thinking she shares the same genes as her father that killed her mother and sisters.
You do.
I know. And if it ever got out, if people knew or even suspected, it would turn me into a freak.
I've survived.
But at what cost?
about one thing.
What?
The darkness invisible in the heart of most killers. Looking at you, no one would ever believe you could even pull that trigger.
Well, they'd be wrong, wouldn't they? Seeger could tell them that. Mary Shaw.
Yeah, but you didn't shoot her. It was an accident. You said so yourself.
It was. So this, in its own way.
No, no, please. No, don't. We can find a way out of this. We can come up with a plan. Please, trust me. Trust me, please. Please. Please.
Just move away from her, Belle. I will only ask you once.
You don't understand.
Shu doesn't understand, Belle. No. I don't have time for hostage negotiations. I've been visualizing that post-mortem, Belle. Seeing that buzzsaw cut you up. I can only mean one thing.
Don't. He didn't do it. Truth is, he's the only innocent person in any of this. Don't.
I'll have to let God decide that, won't we? Be judging us both soon.
You'll still have to come in and give us a statement at some point.
I can give it on camera.
You can give her on a dozen if you want. Sean, why was to accidentally lose this?
Accidentally on purpose, Lucy?
No. Every day, non-conspiracy, lose it. What would that mean to your defense?
Nothing. I'm covered. I'm alibied up.
How's that?
I emailed it to the newspaper before you got here.
things to remember. 6. Never stop filming yourself, ever. Off camera is off guard.
Thank you.